Happy Friday, Centennial Cougars. I'm Gus McMurray.
And I'm Brayden Anderson. Thanks for joining us today. Graduation is now just weeks away.
And the countdown to the end of the year is on.
So today's Tuesday, and we have 66 days left till graduation. How do y'all feel?
Good. I'm excited to go to college and just kind of start life, I guess. But I'm going to miss my favorite teacher, Miss Tally.
What about you?
You know, I'm pretty excited to get out of the school, but I am going to miss some of my friends here and the memories. But, you know, got to move on.
Yeah, well, I'm proud of y'all. Thank you.
Yep. All right, we here with
Miss Calvert.
So how do you feel about graduation coming up in 66 days?
I am beyond excited. I mean, 66 days is like no time at all. And I want to share something with you that's coming up a little closer than 66 days. On April 22nd, which is 1 month away, we have Senior Day, and we have a scholarship ceremony in the morning. And then in the afternoon, we have this really great field day planned that we're working on. On that day, if you are like all caught up and ready to go, you get your cap and gown on that day, which is huge. So April 22nd is like a mile marker, which just brings it home how close graduation is and how close you guys are to walking across that stage. Super excited.
I'm going to be stepping. I can't wait to get my cap and gown. I'm going to do it. Oh, God. I'm going to get my hair redone, get a new lineup. You feel me? But appreciate it, Miss Calvert.
I'm really excited, but I don't know what I'm going to do after. So I'm kind of just like, adult life.
I understand that. I'm a junior, but I'm scared to be a senior. But, you know, but I'm proud of y'all for graduating and finishing.
Y'all know what time it is. Graduation is just 64 days away. 64 days away. So, seniors, it's time for us to grind, motivate, and let's get out of here and all graduate on a good note. Also, don't forget to order your senior signs by April 8th. Always go Cougs.
Prom is just less than a month away.
And you can get your tickets now.
All right, so prom is less than a month away, and tickets just went on sale for about $65. Join us at prom on April 23rd at Ben Ford in Nashville. Prom tickets are now on sale for an early bird price of $65 per ticket, or $70 if you would like the CHS prom shirt with your ticket. Get them at a low price until April 1st. Prom tickets will go up to $75 per ticket after this date. Tickets can be purchased in rooms 206 to 14 with cash or check.
I'm Clay.
And I'm Silas.
And we're back.
And prom's coming up, and we're looking to get our friend Brayden a date. How are you feeling?
This is tragic.
You nervous?
Yes.
You got this?
No, I don't.
It needs to be big. It's got to be a good promposal. You got to think about it.
Elon, he's got this sign. He wants to know, do you think he'll get some chicks with it?
What's the sign?
It says money can't buy love, but can I buy tickets to prom?
That will absolutely work, 100%.
All right, do you have a prom date?
No.
Perfect, bring him out. Say it.
Money can't buy love, but can I buy us our tickets to prom?
Probably not.
Dang! Do any of you ladies have a date to prom?
Undecided.
I do not.
No.
All right, bring him out. Brayden! Read it to him.
Money can't buy love, but can I buy our tickets to prom?
Yes!
Woohoo!
Go hide. Do it.
Brayden, get out of the frame.
Stand back there. Do you guys have a date to prom?
No, not yet, actually.
No.
All right, come here, bro.
Money can't buy love, but can I buy our tickets to prom?
Yes, of course.
Counts for something.
What do you think of this? What's your answer?
Money can't buy love, but can I buy our tickets to prom?
Yes.
Hey guys, just a reminder, make sure you get your prom tickets and a date, or Brayden's going to take your date for you.
Mr. Steel Girl right here. Now here's Madison with more news headlines.
Thanks guys. The Sessions Open Mic Night is this weekend.
So here with
Miss Gossett.
And Ms. Gossett, what do you have planned for this upcoming Sessions open mic?
Okay, so the Sessions is on March 26th, starts at 5:30, and it's going to be so chill, you guys, but also really fun. We have like a little fundraiser where we're selling cookies and pastries. We're going to hang up like twinkle lights, and our sound system is bomb, and there are so many talented people that are going to like be performing all night, so you should definitely come out.
So who are you here with today?
Nika Duncan.
And what are you looking forward to in the upcoming Sessions open mic?
I'm excited to like see people perform again. I always love doing that. And it's really fun to like have the experience of like playing your own songs for people. So
yeah.
Yeah, it's a really cool thing that school does.
Who are you here with today?
Noah Murray.
And what was it like participating in the previous session's event?
It was pretty chill, actually. Microphone's real close.
Sorry.
No, it was pretty chill. We got to work with a bunch of really cool people, a couple previous artists that know the industry really well and just kind of have been around that, like, stage presence and that, I don't know, and they were able to, like, hear all of us individually and work out what they, like, what we could do better, what our strengths, what our weaknesses and stuff.
Yeah.
And then be able to improve on that to kind of perform to your first live audience. I mean, that's the whole goal, is to be able to do that.
Yeah, yeah. What are you looking forward to in the upcoming sessions, open mic coming up?
I'm looking forward to just kind of, I mean, honestly, just to learn more.
Just, like, go out there and play a little bit.
Yeah, just, like, take what I did, how last sessions went for me, and just kind of learn to just have a better live performance.
Nice.
Be sure to see Miss Gossett in room 113 with any questions. The prom isn't the only big event coming up. Here's more on Spring Formal.
Student Council is hosting the Spring Formal this year.
It's from 7 to 10 p.m. on April 8th, and it's for 9th and 10th graders.
And tickets are $10.
This year's yearbook is going to be amazing, and the yearbook staff is celebrating now that the book is on its way to the printer.
All right, guys, breaking news. The yearbook staff just submitted the yearbook. There's still 100 copies left, so you can still buy your yearbook.
It's $105.
So make sure you go get your yearbook, because the past 3 years they've sold out, and you don't want to not have a yearbook.
I'm in yearbook class right now, and we just finished the yearbook, and we're having our award ceremony right now.
So our first awards come in the photography category, and our winner in best action shot is this photo.
Okay, the winners, there's a few that equally deserve recognition here. And then best overall in all categories. So this one would be voted on as the best photo in the book.
Most time invested.
It's on good time.
So go buy your book if you haven't already.
Order number is 373, and you can find it on the Instagram, or it should be on the school website as well.
I just want to give everyone a shout out, like Ainsley said, for creating, I think it's the best yearbook we've ever done.
Aww. And just a couple more items. Saturday credit recovery begins on April 2nd from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. in the library, and will go right up to graduation. And you can support the track team by ordering a taco meal kit from Moe's starting on April 3rd. The link to order is on your screen. That's your headlines, now back to you guys.
You've seen them perform at football games and basketball games.
And now you can be a part of Centennial's amazing dance team.
All right, we're here with people that like dance. So, can I get your guys' names?
Brooke.
Hannah.
Ella.
Kate.
All right, so what is happening with the dance team right now?
We are having tryouts, and on March 30th at 6 p.m., there's going to be a mandatory parent meeting in the library.
All right, anything else to add?
Tryouts are April 6th and 7th in the gym until 4:30 after school.
All right, and didn't the dance team just go to Disney, right?
Yes, we did. We just competed at Disney, and then we also do games, and we do sidelines for basketball and football.
All right, and what's fun about the dance team? You got this. I believe in you. You're doing great.
I don't know how to answer that.
Okay, I'll go. Let me go.
Yeah.
On dance team, we dance at home football and basketball games, and sometimes pep rallies if we have them. And I really enjoy it, and it's also a great way to make new friends.
Anything else you guys want to add?
It's a good bonding experience, and you get to go cool places and see cool dancers, so yeah.
For more information about the dance team, go see Coach Coffin.
All right, I'm here with
Kylie Burgett,
Addison Gorday,
Kaya Cooper, Tyra Petway,
Kennedy Johnson.
And they're all a part of Centennial's flag football team. So what do you guys think of it?
It's exciting for, you know, the first year for us to be the first girls really kicking this off. Don't really know what to expect, but, you know, we're going far.
And when's the first game?
Our first game is this Sunday, 2 and 3.
Yes, and who are you competing against? Anybody?
Franklin High School and Page High School.
And what time does it start?
First game's at 2, second game is at 3, at Franklin High.
Okay, be there.
Be there.
Yeah.
Spring is here and the lacrosse season is underway.
We went out to talk to the boys and girls lacrosse team.
Okay, so I'm here with
Louisa,
Lauren Manlove,
And you guys are on the girls lacrosse team, correct? Mm-hmm. And how's the how do y'all think the season's going to go this year?
Good.
It's going to go okay.
Do y'all think you're going to do better than last year?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, a little bit better.
And are you guys doing anything special, like train or get ready for the season?
At the beginning of the year, we were going to D1 twice a week and practicing, so.
That's good. And do y'all think, like, the new freshmen this year are helping to the team? Y'all think y'all growing as a team?
I mean, I think they're learning pretty quickly, and they're getting the hang of it. I mean, they've only played, like, two games or a few games, but, yeah, they're getting the hang of it pretty fast.
All right, well, thank you. Y'all have a great rest of your season. So I'm here with?
Sydney, Gabby, Ella.
You guys are on the girls' lacrosse team, correct?
Yeah.
And how do y'all feel about the upcoming season, and how do y'all think it's going to go?
I'm really excited, and we have a bunch of new people.
Do y'all think the team got better from last year?
Definitely, yeah.
And are you guys doing anything like special to like train and get ready for the season?
We have practice every day, except for the days we have games. And then that's it.
Well, good luck this season. Thank y'all. So I'm here with?
Dylan.
And you play on the lacrosse team, correct?
Yes.
What position do you play?
Midi.
What's a midi?
It's like the guy that he kind of just runs up and down the field a lot, plays both offense and defense.
And are you excited for the season this year?
Yeah, I'm pretty excited. It's my second year playing, so it'll be a good year.
And you feel like the team is going to be better than next year? Like, are you guys doing anything to get ready for the season?
Yeah, we've been practicing every day, so I think it should be a really good season this year. Yeah.
When's your first game?
This Friday.
Where?
CPA.
What time?
6.
I thought it was against Independence.
Oh, it is against Independence.
What time?
6.
Where?
Independence.
Be there. Good luck this season. Okay, so I'm here with?
Atticus Bro.
Hudson Copeland.
And y'all are both on the lacrosse team, correct?
Correct.
What position do y'all play?
We both play defense. D-pole.
Is that correct?
Yes.
And how do y'all feel about the season coming up here?
I'm feeling pretty good. We've got a good team. Yeah?
Yeah.
And is during practices, y'all getting along? Y'all getting the team ready for the first game?
Yeah, we're getting ready. We're playing Independence on Friday at 6 at Independence, if you want to go.
And y'all think you're going to have a winning season this year?
Yeah, y'all should come and see the Lax boys do their thing. You know, we're going to get the win, like, you know.
Okay, be there at Independence. Good luck this season.
Some CHS students brought their babies to school this week.
But the babies were a little unusual.
I'm Jacob Moore. I'm here with
Sarah Potts.
And who are you?
Hannah Dilling.
Yeah, you are!
What are these?
These are our, like, child eggs that we have to do for health science. And we pretty much just have to decorate them and then treat them like a child for 5 days.
I'm Jacob Moore. I'm here with
Alex.
And Alex, what do you have in your hands?
I have my egg baby in a jar.
Why do you have an egg baby in a jar?
Because it's not going to break this way.
Okay. I'm Jacob Moore. I'm here with
Lucy Shaw.
Lucy, why am I interviewing you?
Well, today was the first day of the egg project, and I kind of...
The what project?
The egg project.
Oh, okay.
With Ms. Club's class, and I kind of, how do I say, my egg died, so.
So why are you doing this? Why do you have eggs? Why are you taking care of them?
It's an assignment.
Yeah, but why is it an assignment?
It's the lesson plan.
It's to help us understand how it's like to take care of a child.
Do you feed your eggs?
No, we do not.
Okay.
It's to, like, physically take care of them, like, carrying them around and, like, not leaving them in a burning car or something like that.
When one of your eggs, when there's an accident, what happens?
We have a funeral.
Do you fail or do you get another one? How does it work?
Well, since it was the first day and she loves me, I think it'll be okay. But usually, like, if it's, like, 4 days in and you, like, if someone else were to break it, then you get in trouble and you get a 0.
So you dropped it on the first day?
Well, it
got smashed.
It got smashed. How long do you have to keep the egg alive?
5 days. Yeah.
Okay. Are you proud of your kids?
Yes, 100%.
Very.
They're all really great friends. It's more of a family type vibe.
Are they friends?
Yeah. Do you and your friends, do they have their eggs fraternized with each other?
You know, we're going to move on.
Oh, is this the one with the mustache, too?
Yeah.
This is one of the witnesses' reports. So-and-so, so-and-so, and so-and-so. I will leave names out of it. You know, Sarah was petting her egg's mustache, and Kate wanted to see it. Kate picked up the egg to see the mustache. Kate was holding the egg, and Sarah came over to her. Sarah was looking at the mustache while Kate was holding it. Then, out of nowhere, Sarah hit Kate's hand. Sarah's egg went flying and hit the floor and went everywhere.
Are real babies this fragile?
No.
Okay.
But can they break? Yes. Yeah. You know, we want to, this is a family learning about parenting and under our growth and development, and that's what they're learning, which includes who's taking care of them when they're not around. You know, they have to have babysitters. They can't leave them in the locker. They have to take them everywhere, even to work.
Back with a new egg. I named him Hey Hey. This is the reference. It's from Moana. And he has a little crib. His name is Dontavius Tyrone DeMarcus III, but we call him Hey Hey. So he's back from the dead.
Yeah. This one's dead.
Yeah.
Now for this week's artist spotlight.
Hashtag 602Kish.
And what do you do for a living?
I make music. Yeah, I'll be chilling.
What kind of music do you make?
Rap. That's all I do. Or it's either I do something else sometimes, like different genres.
What are some of your biggest inspirations to make music?
Growing up, I grew up around music, so I think that just inspired me to make music a lot. Like, if you grow up around it, you just want to try it out and, you know, do it.
Are there any artists that you look up to?
That's a hard question. It's a lot. I can say one is probably Jay-Z or 50 Cent.
Okay, and what platforms do you use to make your music?
It's a thing called BandLab, but sometimes I go to the studio, but for right now I'm using BandLab.
What app is your music on?
SoundCloud, Apple Music, I think that's it. Spotify.
What's your favorite song that you've recorded as an artist?
My favorite song? Probably Letter to God. That was one I wrote.
What's the song about?
It was just writing a letter and just explaining how I feel, like my mindset and like what I want to achieve and like trying to explain something to people.
Awesome. Do you plan on making music, you know, after you're done with high school?
Yeah, definitely, for sure.
All right, cool. Thank you.
That's all our time for now.
Have a great weekend.
Go Cougs!
Okay.